problems have existed within the ranks of the NWO Black and White, to the point that there are no less than five men who claim to be the boss of the New World Order Black and White faction. And as we heard earlier in an interview with our own Mean Gene Okerlund, Big Scott Norton is one of them, and he is going to go one-on-one here on Saturday night with a man that you like to call Mr. World Class, Chip Minton.
Well, I don't like to call him that. He calls himself that. Of course, he was on the Olympic bobsled team.
No less than twice.
Well, that will be once, so yeah, no less than twice. Came up short both times in Nagano and Lillehammer.
What was that?
Lillehammer?
Oh, Norwegia.
Norwegia, yeah. Thank you, Bill Mercer. Speaking of world class, Scott Norton makes his way to the ring. He claims to be the leader of the NWO Black and White, but so does Vincent, so does Horace, so does Big Stevie Ray, so does Brian Adams, and so does everybody else that's ever put on the Black and White. My money is on Big Scott.
Scott Norton claims to be the boss of the NWO Black and White. Are you going to tell him otherwise, Scott Hudson?
No way. I'm not going to tell him anything. Especially how to work his way over here to the announce position. He can figure it out himself. I'm running. Believe me. One of the most unpleasant individuals you'll ever run across. But he backs it up by being strong and powerful. Not a good combination. Mean, strong, powerful, good, talented, endurance, balance, you name it. Scott Norton should be the leader of the Black and White just by attrition. Wrist lock, ducks the clothesline, standing drop kick from Chip Minton. And Mr. World Class, oh, drops the leg on Scott Norton.
Oh, oh. Well, you will see Chip Minton, because of his bobsledding background, primarily rely on his leg strength. Drop kicks, moves like that that we just saw against Scott Norton, and he's also going to have to try and outquick the big man just like that move, and there's the drop kick again.
And you saw it drive Scott Norton directly into the turnbuckle. Big body splash from Chip Minton. Is that it? No. Norton out at two. Oh, man.
He just, like a bull, got to his feet and ran over Chip Minton like a freight train with that clothesline.
And just look at the countenance of Scott Norton. He is not a happy man. Gut wrench. Oh, just a side slam on Chip Minton, and Chip Minton's got to be 260.
You see the ease that he picked up Chip Minton in that gut wrench suplex and took him over and dropped him like a feather. Oh, Chip Minton tries to fight back. No effect with that punch to the midsection that even came up a little short, and Norton comes back with the headbutt.
It's like punching a brick wall. Number one, for all the damage it does to Scott Norton. Number two, how it leaves the fist of Chip Minton feeling. You punch Scott Norton, you might as well punch a brick wall. You've got just as many broken knuckles. And Minton slowly back up to one knee. Norton will shoot him across. Minton into the ropes. Oh, big back elbow from Scott Norton, who wastes very little energy inside that squared circle.
Chip Minton felt at that time coming and going. Pointed the elbow, caught him on the chin. And when he made contact with the canvas, he did it with the back of his head.
And Chip Minton has shown us some things here on... Oh, hang on. Standing drop kick. No. Knife edge chop just leveled Minton. And Minton had a flurry of offense right there, just to no effect on Scott Norton.
Norton just shrugged him off, sets him up in the corner, and there's that back elbow again across the bridge of the nose.
Shoots Minton into the turnbuckle. Oh, the corner splash. That may do it. Whatever was left inside Chip Minton may have just been expelled with that corner splash. Oh, and he's going to inflict more damage. Could it be time for the power bomb? Gut wrench pulls him up. Oh, no. And the merciful end as Scott Norton gets the pinfall on Chip Minton on Saturday night.
What a phenomenal show of strength from Big Scott Norton. As far as I'm concerned, he can be the boss of the Black and White NWO if that's his wish. He goes for the powerbomb, the three count, the pinfall. It's academic from there. Scott Norton scores an impressive win on Saturday night.